Well, in the previous episode, we learnt about the necessity of clutches and how they work, their principle of working. Continuing our discussion, in this episode, we will talk about the cone clutches. Now, the cone clutch has frictional surfaces which come in contact with each other in the form of surface of cone. The cone has got a circular base and a slanting surface. If we look upon the elevation or front view of the cone, the angle made by the slanting surface at the apex is known as cone angle. So this is the diagram of cone clutch. And we will describe it later, but for the time being, you can see that it has got conical frictional surfaces which come in contact with each other. Before we move on to the details of this diagram, let us try to understand how the force acts on this frictional surface. So we have to refer to this diagram which shows the conical surfaces and the force acting on it. We have already seen that the force acts along the axis of the shaft. So it is shown here as P. You find that half cone angle is shown as alpha. I think you can notice it. Now force P is acting axially, and we have representation of it as shown in the diagram. Then you find that this can be resolved into horizontal and vertical component, that is H and Q. Now Q is the force that is acting perpendicularly to the frictional surface. Now this is a simple diagram which shows that the force P has been resolved into two components, and perhaps it is not difficult to understand that the angle between H and Q is equal to alpha, that is half cone angle. Now if we find out relation between Q and H, and I may remind you here that H is equal and opposite to P. So H is equal to P, and we find that we have the relationship between Q and H in the form of Q is equal to H upon sine alpha. I don't think it is very difficult to understand. It is the relationship between perpendicular and hypotenuse. So we have Q is equal to H divided by sine alpha. Now the fact is that the value of sine of angle ranges between 0 and 1. Sine 0 is 0 and sine 90 degrees is 1. So that means the smaller the angle alpha, smaller will be value of sine alpha. Now because it is in denominator, therefore we find that the force Q will be multiplied by this factor. So we have rather higher magnitude of force that is available to us at the frictional surface, acting perpendicular to the frictional surface and causing the friction which transfer the motion from engine shaft to the clutch shaft. We are calling it clutch shaft. This is the output shaft of the clutch. So you find, and in the figure you can refer, left hand side shaft is your engine shaft, and on right hand side we have clutch shaft where we are getting the output. So we find by using the conical surface, the force exerted on the frictional surfaces which causes the transfer of motion becomes more. The magnitude by which force increases depends upon the half cone angle alpha. So of course we have to decide about the best possible smallest angle alpha so that we can have higher magnitude of force available for the transfer of motion on the conical surface. Now we move on to the figure which describes the cone clutch. Now this figure you can find on the left hand side, we have engine shaft, and the end of this shaft is in the form of female cone, which you can find. It has been shown in section here. The right hand side has got clutch shaft, which has got splines. Splines are provided when we want to have relative motion axially, but we don't want any relative motion as far as rotation is concerned. So rotational motion is along with the shaft or the other component, but we can have axial motion in the splines. So you find splined clutch shaft, which is actually the shaft where we are getting the output. Now you find male cone, that is part of the cylindrical component which is capable of moving on the splines. Now this male cone, as you find, has got frictional surface on the outer side, and this has been shown in section here. So this whole thing can move about the axis along the shaft in the splines provided. Also you find that we have another shaft which has got spring, then a bearing. Now this spring provides the required force that we have seen earlier in the diagram as P. Now when this spring is released, so it exerts force on its own, and this causes the movement of male cone towards left, bringing in contact the frictional surface which has been provided on male cone. Now when this surfaces come in contact, we have frictional force, and that causes the transfer of motion from engine shaft to the male cone, and finally it is transferred to the clutch shaft, which has been shown on the right hand side. It may be clarified here that there is no relative motion between the spring shaft and the male cone. They are moving independently of each other, so there is no motion between the male cone and the shaft which has got a spring on it. When we engage the clutch, that means when we are pressing the clutch pedal, we are exerting force against the spring. So it extends, and the contact between the male cone surface and female cone surface is lost. So that is what happens when we are engaging the clutch. But as we release the clutch pedal, we are removing the force that we exert against the force of spring. So the force of spring comes into action and causes the movement of male cone towards left. We gradually leave the clutch pedal, so we are gradually removing the force against the spring. Gradually the force of spring is coming into action, and we have contact between the male cone and the female cone. When the clutch pedal is released completely, the force exerted by spring is sufficient to provide contact between the two surfaces, and motion is transferred from engine shaft to the clutch shaft. So this is how this cone clutch works, and I think I have tried to explain it through a simple diagram. The fact is that if you look upon an actual clutch, you may find the construction to be quite complicated, but that is depending upon so many other requirements which are there. But in the diagram, I have tried to use it in a simpler form so that it can be understood by you easily. So this is about the cone clutch, and in the next episode we will be taking up the single plate clutch. Thank you.